गुड आफ्टरनून टू वन एंड ऑल। सो दिस इज लेक्चर ऑन सीआरटी एंड कलर सीआरटी मॉनिटर्स। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सीआरटी मींस कैथोड रे ट्यूब एंड कलर सीआरटी दैट इज कलर कैथोड रे ट्यूब मॉनिटर्स, द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ इट एंड वर्किंग ऑफ इट। नाउ वी विल बिगिन विद द सीआरटी मॉनिटर्स। सीआरटी मींस इट इज cathode ray tube, CRT, that means cathode ray tube monitors. Now those are also called as black and white displays. Those are black and white displays. Then in CRT monitors, the electron gun emits electron beam on the phosphorus coating, and based on the impact, it will display the picture in a bright or display the brightness. Then focusing, it has a focusing system which controls the converges the electron beam to small spot when it strike to phosphorus coating. I will discuss in detail later. Then this beam, the electron beam, it is moved vertically as well as horizontally using deflection system, and that controls the movement of the beam horizontally and vertically. Now phosphorus coating, it creates bright spot when electron beam strikes on it. So that is nothing but in general discussion of CRT monitors. So we'll discuss in detail what it is, CRT monitor is. Now this is the construction of CRT monitor. Construction of CRT monitors. This is the first part as an electron gun. The use of electron gun is it emits the electrons. Then there is a focusing system. This is the focusing system which controls or which makes the electron or converges the electrons or beam of electrons into a single beam, small beam. It converges all the electrons which are coming from the electron gun into the single beam. So that is the function of focusing system. Then that beam is passing between vertical deflection system and horizontal deflection system. So the vertical deflection system, it controls the movement of electron beam in a vertical direction, in vertical direction, upwards to downwards. And a horizontal deflection system, it controls the movement of the electron beam horizontally. So that this horizontally, it is moving horizontally, then vertical system will take it again. So that vertical and horizontal movement, it will be controlled by using both vertical and horizontal deflection system. So electron beam will move. Then this is the electron beam. Here is the phosphorus coating. Phosphorus coating having property that if you fall electron beam on it, then it will create a bright spot. For some millisecond, it creates the bright spot. Now, here it will be the bright spot if in this case. So that is nothing but phosphorus coating. In CRT monitors, they are using two things. One is persistence of vision, and second thing they are using, the property of phosphorus, and this persistence of vision, it is the property of our eye. So what is meant by persistence of vision? So whenever, if suppose here is the beam, you are seeing this beam. Suppose here is the beam, you can see, but if I move this beam slowly, then you can see the position easily. But if I move this very fast, then you can see that as a circle. Means what? Our eyes are retaining the position for some amount of time. If suppose this is the position, next position is this one. So earlier position, because of movement, it is so fast, our eyes are retaining the positions which are last positions. And because of that, we are seeing this as a continuous or as a circle. Continuous as a circle. So that is nothing but the property as called as persistence of vision. So in displays, in monitors, that property is used. Now, suppose this is the front view of the display, front view of the display, then electron beam will start moving. Electron beam will start moving, or it starts scanning from this upper left corner. It will start scanning from upper left corner. The beam will move, and wherever there is, suppose I want to display A, then this is the one scan line. This is the horizontal way. The electron beam will move from here, then one scan line at a time, then it will move second, then it will move third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and whenever the beam will reach at this position, it will display the point. It will display the point. Again, in next line, those two points will be displayed, means their impact will be created. Then next, those two pixels or points will be displayed. In next line, those four points will be displayed by that electron beam. Then next two, then next two. Similarly, this electron beam will move to this particular position, that is nothing but the last left corner. Then again, it will retrace or retrieve back to the first position. Then again, it will continuously scan this and repetitively display that particular pixels. And because of that only, this A will be stable. Otherwise, what will happen? Once the electron beam scans this one, it will be displayed. Whenever it will go to next, then next, the first pixel will be vanishes, or first point will be vanished. And because of that, we can't get the impression that this is A. So that in CRT monitors, that electron gun or electron beam, it scans the whole screen minimum 16 times per second, minimum 16 times per second. So in case of persistence of vision, if you are repeating the things 16 times per second, then you will get the continuous beam. If suppose you are having the fan, if it is in off state, then you can find the three blades. But if it is in on state and it is moving, then at that time we can't identify the blades, because they are continuously moving, they are continuously rotating, and because of that, it will be like a plane. We are getting it as a plane. So that is nothing but called as persistence of vision. So to retain that dots, or retain that A letter, this pattern should be repeated minimum 16 times per second, so that electron beam will start scanning from upper left corner. It will scan one line at a time till the end, again back to the first position, again then it will scan, then again will go to first position. So this is nothing but how the beam is moving. So beam is moving from here to here, so that is controlled by which deflection system? Horizontal deflection system. Then this beam will reach to that position and it will come down to the next. So that is nothing but who is controlling? Vertical. Then next. Again, from this position, last position, to the first position, again the beam is going in a vertical direction. That is controlled by vertical deflection system. So CRT monitor working or the scanning, it is similar to our reading. Whenever we are reading the book, at that time we are reading one line at a time. Then we are going in the second line, means from the right side, left side. Then again reading towards right side. Then again coming to the left side, then right side, left side, right side. So means our reading of a book is similar to the scanning of the CRT monitor, scanning. So it will start scanning from upper left corner, one line at a time, then coming back down, then next, till the end, and then going back again to the first position. So that is nothing but how the CRT monitor is working. And this electron beam is very small quantity, very small focus, so that to retain that particular letter or any pattern, this pattern must be repeated minimum 16 times per second. It must be repeated minimum 16 times per second. So that is nothing but requirement of the pattern retention. Now, once again, I will explain it in detail how it is or how it is working, the monitors. Okay, this is suppose monitor, then electron beam will begin from this upper left corner, then it will scan one line, then it will go to next line, then will go to next line, then go to next line, and wherever you want to display something, at that time this pixel point or pixel will be displayed. Then next, then next, then next, those are displayed. Suppose this pattern I want to display, then that pattern will be retained it will be repeated again and again for retention, minimum 16 times per second. So this electron beam is continuously moving like this, and this pattern will be retained. So generally in today's computers or in displays, there are some things that is nothing but frame buffer and all that we'll discuss later. So this is nothing but how the monitors or CRT monitors are working. So what is the use of it? So what is the use of phosphorus? Phosphorus is creating the bright spot. And whenever there is no bright spot, that is a dark. If suppose there is a bright spot, this is the white, right? And if whenever there is no bright spot, this is the dark. So the earlier monitors were black and white monitors, means black color, black and white, and using the combination of black and white, that is also called as grayscale. So using that black and white combination, the pictures are displayed on the monitors. Hence, those CRT monitors will be called as white, black and white monitors also, because they are creating the patterns, they are creating the pictures with the help of two colors, that is white and black. And the combination of it, that is nothing but called as grayscale, using grayscale. Now next, it is a color CRT monitors. In black and white monitors, or in you can call it as CRT monitors, there are how many electron guns? There is one electron gun. And using that one electron gun, they are creating the patterns or variations of grayscale, and that is nothing but there are two colors, black and white. Now in color CRT monitors, the colors, there are infinite number of colors. Now is it feasible to put infinite number of electron guns? No, we can't put infinite number of electron guns. So for that purpose, in color CRT monitors, they are using three electron guns. One for R, one for G, and one for B. R means red, green, and blue. And the combination of three, using the combination of RGB, they are creating the various colors. Combination of three, RGB. We know this is by combining red and green, you can combine G and B, you can combine the proportion of RGB, and various color shades can be displayed. So that particular technique is used in the color CRT monitors. There are infinite number of colors. We can't have infinite number of electron guns to create that colors. So instead of that, in CRT monitors, they are using three electron guns and three phosphorus coatings. There are three phosphorus coatings, one for related to red, one is G, one is B, and there are three RGB guns. And using that guns, they are creating the color patterns. One is for red, one is for green, one is for blue. And combined resultant color of three colors is perceived by the viewer. So if you combine red, green, blue, based on proportions, the color will be displayed differently. If you are doing this one, if you add green, red, green, blue like this, so if you add RGB equally, if you add R plus G plus B, it is nothing but white. It will create white. If you add R plus G, you can add B plus G. So different color shades will be created. So that is nothing but called as color model. Color model. Color model. So there is a RGB color model, and using that RGB color model, you can create various number, various shades of the color. So that is nothing but CRT monitors. Otherwise, the working of the color CRT monitor is similar. Means there are three electron guns. They are emitting the. There is a focusing system, the deflection system that is creating the moment of the beam. So this is nothing but the working of CRT monitors, color CRT monitors. So there are three electron guns. There are three electron guns. Three electron guns. And on monitor, there are three coatings. There are three coatings. And for each pixel, if suppose this pixel, then to display related to each pixel, there is a shadow mask in between the electron gun and monitor. There is a shadow mask between monitor and electron gun. And that shadow mask will control or will pass the electron beams. If suppose I want to display this picture or pixel, then that electron guns, whenever it will pass from this particular hole, this is in the hole. There is shadow mask means they are having holes related to pixels. So through that holes, that electron beams will pass, and this pixel, at that pixel, three colors will be displayed, and combination of three will be perceived by our eyes, because our eyes cannot identify very minute details. If suppose somebody wear the shirt with black and white pattern, and if he is very near to us, then definitely we can identify he has have the shirt with the black and white strips. But if he is at some location, means some distance between you and him, then you can find that may be black if the black color is more. So means our eyes cannot identify the minute details. And that particular advantage is taken to display that particular colors. And then that beams are moving. And as per the moment, as per the information, those pixels will be displayed. So this is nothing but how they are moving. They are moving horizontally. They are the next line, next line, next line. So this is called as one. This is called as pixel. This is a small called as pixel. Pixel means it is a picture element. picture element and one row of pixels. This is the one row of pixel that is called as scan line. So this beam is scanning the pixels horizontally, one line at a time, then going to the next, then next, and the whole screen is scanned, and as per the data, as per the display, it will be displayed, and that will be retained. For retention, it must be repeated 16 times per second, minimum 16 times per second. Then and then only that pattern will be retained on the monitors. Then a few concepts related to display devices we will discuss. In today's era, we are dealing with the digital world or digital displays, where the things are, various things are related concept we'll discuss, like pixel. So first will be pixel. What is meant by pixel? Pixel is the picture element. This is the pixels. Pixel is very small, but for display purpose or showing it, I'm showing it bigger. But what is the size of pixel? If suppose I am having the dot, so that is the size of pixel. You can see, this is a very small size as a one pixel on this monitor. So there are multiple pixels from this end to that end, and then vertically also. But for explanation purpose, I am taking pixel size somewhat more or somewhat bigger. So this is smallest unit of the picture. So what is a pixel? Pixel is nothing but picture element. Now pixel, you can define the pixel. Pixel is the smallest addressable location on the screen. It is the smallest addressable. You can give the address like a coordinate in coordinate terms. Addressable location on the screen, that is called as pixel. It is also called as pel. Now after pixel, here you can see this is the one scan line, means row of pixel, row of pixel is called as scan line. Scan line. Then complete, this is complete row and columns, means this is like a matrix. There are vertical pixels, horizontal pixels. So complete, this complete picture, complete one, row and column of the pixel, it is called as raster, called as raster. So this is called as raster. So we'll discuss it. Here you can see. So this is nothing but a pixel. Pixel means it is the smallest addressable location on the screen. Scan line means one row of pixel. Row of pixel is called as scan line. Row of pixel is called as scan line. And complete row into columns means complete this complete screen. Number of rows by means number of columns. So that is called as raster. One more thing I would like to say, whenever we are saying size of the screen, whenever we are buying the mobile, at that time we are thinking whether what is the size of screen, mobile screen, it may be 6 inch like this. So what is the size actually? So size of the display, it is measured diagonally. Measured diagonally. This is nothing but the size from this corner till this corner. So diagonally, size of the screen is measured. Size of the screen is measured. Now start from pixel. What is the definition of pixel? Pixel, it is the smallest integer addressable location on the display. Now the pixel is also known as PEL or picture element, and the pixel on the screen having the location x comma y. So I will show you how this location will be calculated. Now see, if suppose this is XY coordinate system, XY coordinate system. This is XY coordinate system. This is the first, means X, and you can say Y. So each pixel is represented by location X comma Y. So you can have the location. This is the first location. This is second. This is third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. There are 18 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. There are 12 rows. Suppose this is the pixel. I want to find what is the location of this pixel. I want to find what is the location of the pixel. So this is 6th column, means 6. X coordinate is 6. What is the Y? It is 6. 6, 6. Means each pixel having location on the screen. If suppose this is the pixel, and I want to find what is the location of pixel, then this is a 15th row, 15 comma 10, 15 comma 10. So each pixel on the screen or display having the integer addressable location, integer, it never, pixel doesn't have address like 15.25, never. It will be 15 or it will be 16. So integer addressable location. Always remember, pixels are represented by integer addressable location. So that pixel, it is smallest integer addressable location, as we have discussed. Now second point is scan line. What is scan line? The row of pixel is called as scan line. If suppose this is the display screen, then it is divided into number of rows and number of columns as a pixel. Those are the pixels. Suppose each location is pixel, then this is called as one scan line. Scan line, one scan line. This is second, third scan line, fourth scan line. So scan line means row of pixels. Scan line means row of pixels. Then next, the raster. So what do you mean by raster? So raster is an array of pixels on the screen. Raster is an array of pixels on the screen. Array means, you know, in C language, you are defining the two-dimensional array. So this is nothing but array. Array, how many rows and how many columns? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns. So you can write it as 5 by 7. So this is the array of 5 by 7. So complete array of pixel on the screen is called as complete array of pixel. It is called as screen raster. So that is the concept of raster. So complete screen, it is called as raster. Hence, whenever we are scanning line by line, that is called as raster scanning. That is called as raster scanning. We are scanning the complete screen with the help of pixel, with the help of beam, and that is called as raster scanning. Now, next concept related to displays are aspect ratio. Now, what is meant by aspect ratio? Aspect ratio, it is nothing but a ratio of width of the screen, ratio of width of the screen to the height of the screen, width of the screen to the height of the screen. Now see here, if suppose this is the display, if you suppose this is the monitor or display, this is nothing but width, this is nothing but height. Then the aspect ratio, it is nothing but width as to height, width as to height. And you can see there are standard, few standard aspect ratios are written, 4:3, 16:9, 20:9. 21:9. Now see here, the width of the in aspect ratio or in displays, the width is more than the height. Always remember, many of the displays, monitors, TVs, they are having width more than the height. Now what is the reason why width is more than the height in the displays? So first reason is, as a human being or as animals or as living things, our most of the movement happened in the horizontal direction. We are walking, means we are moving in the horizontal direction. Whenever we are driving a car, it is in horizontal direction. So most of the things we are doing in the horizontal direction. Second reason is our eyes, structure of our eyes. Suppose those are the eyes, our eyes. Then structure of our eyes are, eyes can see horizontally, 180 degree from this left side to right side, minimum 180 degree you can see. And how much vertically the eyes can see? Eyes can see 120 degree. 120 degree portion can be covered by eyes in vertical direction. In horizontal direction, 180 degree at least we can see by our eyes. So because of that, the most of the things or most of the displays are wide, means they having width more than the height. Even if suppose we are using mobile phone, mobile is generally vertical. But whenever we are watching movie on a mobile phone or playing games, at that time we are making it horizontal. Means more width we want than the height. So that is called as aspect ratio. So general standard aspect ratios, 4:3, 16:9, 21:9. So that is called as aspect ratio. And last concept of the display related to display is size of the display. As I have discussed, the size of the display, it is measured along the diagonal in inches. If suppose this is a display and I want to find the size of the display. So where is the size of the display? So display is measured in size as a diagonal. This is the size of the display. Whenever we are buying mobile phone, we want at least 6.5 inch of screen. So that what it indicates, 6 inch means the diagonally that is a 6 inch. It is never horizontally or vertically. It is a diagonally. It is diagonally 6 inch or 6.5 inch. So that is all about size of the display, related concept, CRT monitor. Then we have discussed what is the color monitor, color screen, what is pixel. And we have discussed what is the working of CRT monitors, what is the working of means black and white monitors. So you must how that particular view in CRT monitors or in color monitors. In inside the monitors in digital devices or digital displays, there is one thing available that is nothing but called as frame buffer. One as a frame buffer. Now see what is meant by buffer. Buffer means it is a temporary storage. Suppose we are having less means internet speed, low internet speed. At that time, our YouTube video is buffering sometime and then playing, then buffering, then playing. So buffering means it is a temporary storage. Actually, buffer means a temporary storage. Now, what do you mean by frame buffer? In displays, whenever you want to, okay, in displays, suppose this is the display. Whenever you want to display something, if suppose I want to display A on the screen, then behind the display, there is an area or memory. There is a memory that is called as frame buffer. Memory, frame buffer. This is the temporary storage behind the screen. Suppose those are the pixels. Those are the pixels. Those are the pixels. Then in frame buffer also, there are related locations. This first pixel on the screen, the same location information will be stored in the frame buffer and this location. Means frame buffer, it is nothing but a temporary storage which is just behind the display, which having current pixel information in terms of grayscale or color to be displayed on the screen. If suppose it is white, or you can say it is 5, then related color will be displayed at that pixel. If suppose it is 6, related color will be displayed on this pixel. Means inside the computer display, behind the actual display, there is a temporary storage that is called as frame buffer. So frame buffer means it is a temporary storage behind the display which stores the pixel information. It is current pixel information. Now suppose next time I want to have B, then that information will be stored in the frame buffer. So frame buffer is temporary storage in the computer behind the display, behind the display, which stores the grayscale information or colors information which will be displayed on the screen. Because why it is required? Because we have to repeat the pattern 16 times per second to retain the pattern. If suppose there is no frame buffer behind the display, then that information will come from and it will lag. And because of that, there is a frame buffer behind the display. So remember, frame buffer is nothing but the temporary storage which is behind the display. So we have discussed many things related to display and display devices, color monitors, CRT monitors. So thank you for joining this session.